again, the sound reminds us. It's time for another Wednesday edition, middle of the week, as we go into the first week of June 2022. And we are in a difficult place in terms of life and business right now, but hopefully we'll learn not only to survive, but to thrive. And that's about the subject for today. How can we do that? So I would ask you to join me just for about 12 or 15 minutes, maybe a little bit less. Not anymore, because I have some thoughts that might be helpful to you on the program today. And I also want to remind you, a little bit of a teaser, tomorrow I have the privilege of introducing you to a gentleman who is helping to save the world, and at least a small portion of it, by making beds. That's right, making beds. And in doing so, he is doing his part to make this a far better world and a far better place. And you'll enjoy hearing his story about how that happens and what he does and how it does, in effect, make a difference in the world. As one of my mentors one time said to me, Stan, the things that are really important never make the news. They're happening all over and they're happening everywhere, but you won't ever notice them because they never make the news unless somebody is smart enough and kind enough to do a radio program and perhaps help hold them up and, in effect, show them off for the world to see. So we're going to be about that. In fact, that's what this entire program is all about, helping people who are not normally professional people in the media, because you know, you don't have to go very far to find out that so many people in the professional media don't have any interesting ideas, and they're not really very interesting people, but they are here, and they're on the program from time to time, and occasionally maybe I will even have an interesting idea, and we'll see if that's the case today. Yes, the program is Interesting Ideas, and it starts right now. Yes, things are difficult. Right now, the prediction of a recession is upon us. And so here we go again. We thought this would be better. 2020 would be a good year. Well, we know what happened. 2021, well, we will recover. Well, we know what happened. 2022, we are recovering, but does that mean that we now are going to head into some recessionary times because we just simply aren't doing things right? And the world is, as you know, caught in so many situations that we just don't know what to do many times. Well, may we pray for wisdom, and please take me seriously there. Pray for wisdom, some insight and some truth, and the courage to do what we need to do, and hopefully that others will also do what they need to do. I'd like to talk about something that I used to mention quite often in my professional career as a business performance coach. Even though now this radio work is my full-time work, I still do a lot of what I was made for, and that is to tell stories, ask good questions, share interesting ideas, and see if I couldn't help men and women who wanted to make a difference in the world and build a business that mattered in the world do just that. Now, here's my truth forever, in particular for today. Today, we all need to learn how to market ourselves. We have to market our services and our products, and we have to do it in unique and distinctive ways. Okay, there's the interesting idea, but it's pretty general. We need to be able to communicate clearly, all right, concisely, crisply, and with a touch of wisdom to show people that we bring value into their life. We actually are useful and practical for them and for their life and business. And we must do so not just by speaking, but we must then by our performance. We got to perform, And then by our demonstration, we have to demonstrate that we really are what we claim to be, valuable, helpful, useful, and practical. Got that? Valuable, helpful, useful, and practical. There's the big four. And then our speech and our style must be matched with substance and solid achievements. I'm quite proud of that statement. I came up with it some time ago, and I drug it out, and I hope it was helpful. But listen to it again if you want to. Now, this is particularly important if you're self-employed and perhaps building your own business, or you're in professional sales and marketing. But may I add to that? The smart person today, it may not be self-employed, but they are thinking as a self-employed. They're not maybe building their own business, but they are very much aware that the services and the work they do is the way they do build, in some way, their own business. They may be working for another business, but in many ways they're building their own business. And whether you believe it or not, everybody is in sales and marketing, including you, because you have to sell and market yourself. Now, we were talking with one of these professional salesmen at one time about some of the qualities that he needed to do a good job. And then he said, well, Stan, you know, the problem is that for those of us in sales, we procrastinate a lot. we just don't get around to it. And then he made a very wise statement. He said, the problem is that if you're in sales and marketing, and sometimes if you are in business, you don't really act until some survival is at stake. He said, otherwise, you're just kind of doing what you do. And that's not acting. And boy, was there wisdom there. If you're just doing what you do or doing what you've always done, you're not acting. All right, so we only act when we survive or need to survive. And then I said, and I'm grateful for this insight, and he smiled, and I said, that's the problem. We not only need to act to survive, but before we act, we need to think to survive, and we need to think to thrive. If you want to survive in the coming recessionary or difficult times, right now, on this first day of June, as we go into the summer and we're trying to make the second half work, start thinking more, thinking better, and think every day. And that's why I talk about having interesting ideas. It's because whether they're good or not, they cause you to think and say, oh, I hadn't thought about that, or that's a new idea, that's unique. Oh, that's a waste of time. My way is much better. And if it's true, then you know that. So that's what I want you to encourage yourself to do. Think in order to thrive. Well, in the rest of the program, I'm going to try and give you some ideas of how you should do that and why you should do it. The program is Interesting Ideas. My name is Stan Husted. I believe I can help you in some significant way. Reach out to me and the work we do. First of all, you need to have your own radio program. You need to have your own video presentation. And that's what we do at What It Takes Radio. What It Takes Radio is witradio.net. Check us out, witradio.net. If you Google Stan Husted, you will find all kinds of stories and suggestions that I have done throughout my life and work, and you might find something even from past times that is helpful to you. Or why don't you just reach out to me personally at stanhusted@gmail.com, stanhusted@gmail.com. And remember, you have to think in order to thrive. We'll be right back. Right now, we're hearing a lot of, well, do something. Well, that's bad advice. If that's the only kind of advice you have, dismiss it. Don't just do something. First, think. Talk. Pray. Listen. Perhaps have a conversation. Ask for special wisdom. And then perhaps, then do one thing. One thing that there are very, very good possibilities that it will not solve the problem, but it will make the situation better. All right? Don't just do something. All right? Thinking is what makes you successful in today's economy. You have to have good ideas to be successful. Okay. Products, programs, services, and the latest technology. Oh, I got all that, Stan. Okay, good for you. You're just one of many who do too. So what? It is when you have unique, creative, and distinct ideas that people will value you and recommend you to others. I oftentimes say, don't ask for referrals, deserve recommendations. Don't ask for referrals, deserve recommendations. So, the vital difference is you. You have to become the business that you are in. People are not buying your products or your services, they are buying you. And so the more interesting you are, the more style you have, the greater performance you give, the more wisdom you show, the more attractive you are in the best possible sense of the word. And that doesn't mean you're particularly good looking, whatever that might mean. In fact, some of the best looking people in the world are the least attractive people in the world. And I think you're smart enough to get my meaning. All right? So here's what you can do. Take time every day to just read and think in your area of expertise. Just do that. 10, 15, 20 minutes every day. Also take time to read in many other areas of life and literature. Now, be aware and seek to capture good ideas about anything. Be just a capturer, a go-getter. Now, one of the things I encourage you to do a podcast or to be a radio person is, I just learned, as one of my friends said, Stan, where do you come up with all this stuff? I said, well, for 30 or 40 years, I was always in the mindset of, I need to learn something, think something, do something that somebody will want to hear. And being a broadcaster makes you aware of everything. You're always looking out for things, whether it's a good joke or whether it's an interesting bumper sticker. You're always saying, what could I do with this in a way that would be helpful and useful to me and to others? So do that. Get in the life-changing and life habit of seeking out ideas. One of my friends helped me. He says, sit down, Stan. And this is what he did. He said, every morning I come down and I just write down my ideas. That's all I do. Any idea that I have in my mind right now, I just write it down. Don't necessarily act on it, but I just write it down. Okay. Learn from others. And, of course, seek your own ideas. Come up with something original, something unique. The key to success is not mindfulness, and that's partly true, but there's a better term. It's thoughtfulness. And I mean that in both ways. You are thoughtful of others, and you are thoughtful about the world and yourself. You're thinking. Then in conversations with clients and colleagues, prospects, you will oftentimes be able to say these three wonderful words. I've been thinking. And oftentimes, the best way to sell somebody is not to say, hey, here's what you need. It's to simply begin by saying, you know, I've been thinking. And share what your thought is. And that may lead to a conversation in which they will respond to your thinking, not just to perhaps the product or service you're hopefully getting them to get involved in. Share your wisdom and your ideas, and do it all the time. That's why I want to get you on the radio, so you can do that. You can share your ideas with the whole world and see what happens. When you do that, it will go well with you because you will no longer be only acting to survive. Hey, you'll be thinking to thrive. I'm Stan Houston. These are Interesting Ideas. Thank you for your time. Just about 15 minutes. That's all we need. And we want to help you. In some way, I know we can, or we know people who can. So particularly in your life, in your business, is there something you need to perhaps do differently, be more creative, have some suggestion for how you could do it differently, or you would just simply like to embrace the idea that you have an audience of people out there and you need to reach them. You have an audience, or you want an audience, and you need to reach them with your wisdom, insight, and truth, and perhaps the good things that you have that will be good and helpful to them. We can help you do just that. Reach out to me. First of all, you might want to check out our story, which is witradio.net, witradio.net, and we'll do it personally, I guarantee. I'll get back to you. That's what I do. StanHouston@gmail.com. StanHouston@gmail.com. I hope Wednesday is not just a hump day. I hope it's a thump day. That means that you just kind of nailed it. You thumped it. You got something good and powerful and worthwhile, and you got it done today. Best and blessings to you as you kind of thump your day. And go your way. Bye for now.